All right, now one of my all-time favorites. Last but certainly not least, I'll start the introduction of her with this tune. Okay, hit it. That's Heat Wave, ladies and gentlemen, from Martha Reeves and the Vandellas, Miss Martha Reeves. Hello, honey. Martha. I met Martha in New Orleans some months back, and I put it in my mind to do this show then. She is charming as she is talented. Now, Martha Reeves and the Vandellas are still playing all over the country. You have a tour of Europe going on, don't you?
Bless your heart, Geraldo. I watch you every morning. I never thought I'd be on your show. It's just wonderful.
I love those earrings. Look at those music notes.
Thank you so much.
Now, you started as a secretary in Motown.
I started as a singer.
And
I had to be a secretary to get to the singing position, but I started as a singer.
Well, tell me about that first day.
William Stevenson, who is Kim Weston's ex-husband.
I get a feeling that this is all going to be interrelated today. So
he came to the 20 grand while I was working at the Happy Hour. I'd been awarded a Happy Hour by winning a contest. You couldn't really sing in the olden days unless you won a contest, amateur contest. And William Stevenson, better known as Mickey, who I refer to as Mickey, walked in and handed me a card and said, come to Motown. I had a job at the cleaners, and I was working at the nightclub on the weekends. I quit that job on the spot. I was there the next morning at 9 o'clock. There was no A&R secretary, so I became the first A&R secretary at Motown.
And then how'd you get off the secretarial desk and into the recording booth?
Well, you know what unions are, right? The union came in, and somebody had to be on the mic as they recorded, and fortunately, it was a Mary Wells record, one in my key. It became my first recording.
That's amazing. A heat wave, I mean, that so characterized the whole nation back then. Did you feel that you were the center of attention? I mean, that company and everything that was going on, you were defining music in this country for those years in the early 60s.
Not the center. I was a part of a wonderful movement. I was not the center. I don't know anyone that was the center in the first days. We were all like at a girls' camp or a guys' camp. Everybody pitched in and did whatever they could. We sang back up for each other. We clapped for each other. We helped each other along. So there were no real superstars in the beginning.
Did you have any favorites among your colleagues there at Motown?
Well, everybody was a favorite. Everybody had the same thing in common. We all sang and were all the most talented in Detroit. Barry Gordy had the knack of gathering up the most talented people in Detroit.
What do you think of Barry and his contribution? You know, it's Ray's written the book. It's a bit controversial. What do you think of Barry Gordy when you look back?
Well, I know the man personally, but not intimately, so it'd be a lot that I can't really speak on.
Ray says there's quite a few that know him intimately.
If I have to stand here and fight everybody else, I will say that Barry is one of the most talented geniuses I've ever met. He knew exactly what people wanted to hear, and he told us what to do, and we all listened. He knew what to do, and he told us all. He critiqued each show, and he came to us individually and gave us all the little tips that we're using right now in show business. So I got to look up to him. I herald him, and I reward him with success.